everybody, how's it going? Today, let's take a detailed look at the 2008 Buick LaCrosse Super. The Buick LaCrosse Super is more than just a counterpart of the Chevrolet Impala SS as well as the Pontiac Grand Prix GXP. It was actually specifically designed and built by GM's performance division, same people responsible for the Cadillac V-Series cars. And this is going to be a detailed, in-depth review of the LaCrosse Super. We'll start it up, show the engine, get an exhaust clip, and go over the performance data, as well as show you a bunch of the unique aspects of the interior as well as exterior.
And a special thanks and big shout out go out to the Flo GM Auto Center in Winston-Salem, North Carolina for allowing me to come out and film this beautiful Buick LaCrosse Super.
And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start her up, let her run. As you can see, the Super does come standard with a remote start. The exterior color is known as platinum metallic and features a titanium gray leather interior. Specifically designed for the Super, more on that in just a little bit. Beautiful burble from that 5.3 small block V8. One of the first things you notice about the LaCrosse Super is its unique gauge treatment. Blue, accented by chrome rings, with the Super moniker located in the bottom of the speedometer cluster. A beautiful sporty touch. The steering system has also been completely reworked for the Super. It features a modified version of Buick's magnetic variable assist rack and pinion steering system, where the rack, the teeth, are actually stiffer and associated closer together, which in tune give the LaCrosse a little bit more of a driver feel to it, makes it a little bit more responsive, and gives it a little bit of a tighter feedback, so to speak, which makes the driving experience a lot more fun, if you will, versus the Impala SS or the Grand Prix GXP. Nice and smooth. Fully leather wrapped with chrome Buick medallion located front and center. Also, the only transmission option is a 4-speed automatic gearbox with low gear selection, accented in wood as well as in chrome housing. And so, we'll go ahead and cut on the automatic headlamps, fog lamps, as well as the hazards. Driver's side windows automatic. And we're going to check out the exterior, shall we?
The Buick Super moniker was first introduced in 1940 and would designate the brand's more upscale mid-range model, which was a step up from the entry-level Buick Special, until 1958, where the name was then dropped from future use. Now, over 50 years later, Buick brings back that famous name in the newly refreshed LaCrosse for 2008. Since 1958, Buick has always produced its special performance cars, such as the Grand National of the 1980s, the list goes on. As the average age of purchaser increased steadily through the 90s and 2000s, Buick decided to revitalize the brand as a premium motor car for the younger generation. The 2008 LaCrosse Super was that answer. It shares basic construction and platforms with the Chevrolet Impala, Monte Carlo, and the Pontiac Grand Prix. Only this one, like I said earlier, was specifically designed by GM's performance division to make it faster, handle better, stop quicker, and have more overall high-speed stability than either of its siblings. All LaCrosse models for 2008 also saw a deserving refresh from its introduction in 2005, which included an all-new bold waterfall grille with larger front air dam housing larger fog lamps. You also saw revitalized styling all the way around to blend both edgy lines and elegant curves. The Super also gets its own unique touches as well, most notably being the four portholes on each side that designate that small block V8 hiding under the hood. Beginning with the wheels, the Super features unique 18-inch aluminum alloy units wrapped in 235/50 tires. Unlike the Grand Prix GXP, the tires are not wider in the front than the back, but with the suspension advancements to manage the torque steer, they didn't need to be. To deal with the increased stopping needs, the brakes in the Lucerne were utilized and measure an inch bigger in the front and 0.3 inches in the rear. In short, it basically mirrors the brake setup of the GXP in the front and the SS in the rear. The car also features tuned springs, beefier anti-roll bars, as well as Bilstein monotube dampers that maximize the force placed on each wheel to keep ground contact when going through a corner. And last but not least, the traction control system was also tweaked just a little bit to allow for more spirited driving so it won't kick in necessarily quite as early as the standard car would. The Super is also the most loaded LaCrosse trim, comes with every option including rear parking sensors, sunroof, as well as power heated exterior mirrors. As you come across the back here, follow the line, the rear is very similar to a traditional LaCrosse. You'll notice that the little backup lamps actually integrate with that curve and the scooped out portion going across the rear deck lid. You'll also notice the more pronounced and more robust rear clip housing the dual chrome exhausts with 3.5-inch chrome tips that deliver a nice low-tone V8 growl. The LaCrosse Super is a definite sleeper body styling. It has a unique rear spoiler, some unique body cladding, but aside from the Super badging, it really doesn't designate itself that much more from the rest of the brand or even a Lucerne, which definitely makes it that much more unique and special, especially for somebody wanting that undercover feel, so to speak. The LaCrosse has an overall length of 200.4 inches with a width of 72.9 inches and a height of 58.7 inches. Total curb weight is around 3,791 pounds.
And we're going to pop the hood.
The Super features GM's 5.3 liter overhead valve small block V8 and puts out 300 horsepower at 5,600 rpm and 323 pound-feet of torque at 4,000 rpm. The vehicle is front-wheel drive, and while that tends to mean a bit of torque steer, it's very well controlled thanks to the engineering put forth during its development. 0 to 60 times are around 5.7 seconds with a quarter-mile time of 14.2 seconds at 101 miles per hour. But most importantly, top speed is an awesome 156 miles an hour, making it not necessarily the quickest, but overall the fastest Buick produced through 2008. The suspension is fully independent with modified McPherson struts up front and a semi-trailing arm rear suspension. As far as fuel economy ratings, running on regular unleaded gas with a 17-gallon tank, the Super achieves a rating of around 16 city, 24 highway.
The LaCrosse Super gets its own custom luxury unique treatment that sets it apart from the standard LaCrosse models. Overall, the design is very similar. Padded door panels located up top, lower storage in the two-tone color scheme, all of your power windows, power mirrors, power locks like you saw earlier, as well as chestnut wood trim coming across the doors, dash, and center console. The bucket seats in the Super feature power sliding, tilting with manual recline, uniquely leather trimmed, and heavily side bolstered compared to the standard LaCrosse, so you have a lot more lateral grip for a little bit more driving enjoyment. Also, specifically for the Super model, there's a unique perforated leather trim coming across the middle of the seat known as Dream Weave. Now what that means is it's stitched in a way to kind of give you the appearance of woven leather in between itself. So it's definitely unique. Brushed aluminum door sills, logoed floor mats, as well as a manually tilting steering wheel. So let's go ahead and see how she sounds. There is a rev limiter in park and neutral around 4,000 RPM. And while it does have a throaty, burly V8 exhaust note, it's actually been toned down just a little bit, being that this is more of a luxury-oriented car, versus its GXP or SS counterparts. Shut her up. Nice and solid. The LaCrosse also features an upgraded 9-speaker audio system with in-dash CD player. Side curtain airbags. Garage home link located on the mirror. And if you come up to the top center stack here, you have your interior illumination, as well as controls for your power sunroof. The entire center stack is accented by satin silver, gives a nice metallic sheen to it. Standard dual zone climate control located down below. Nice and simple, quite familiar to the rest of the GM lineup. Heated seats for both the driver and passenger located on each side, different zones, front and rear defrost, recycling, fan speed, as well as one-touch automatic. As far as the radio itself, it's also very quite simple. In-dash CD player like you saw earlier, your different preset stations, equalizer settings, as well as changing between your different band, XM satellite radio, CD, tune, clock, as well as song information if displayable. Pretty self-explanatory. Located next to the vehicle's traction control system is an integrated driver information system. This shows up in the little digital display below the speedometer. Trip computer. Fuel economy data. Vehicle systems. Tire pressure monitoring system. As well as personalizable options. Lower storage down below with integrated 12-volt power outlet. Two cup holders. Padded stitch center console with plenty of storage. Also, to control your door ajar light, as well as your speedometer cluster brightness. Going across the steering wheel, you have your cruise control off to the left, as well as your radio controls off to the right with volume located on the back. Alrighty. Gonna shut her down. And we'll check out the back seat. Back seat occupants for the LaCrosse are treated in the same amount of comfort as the front, if not just a little bit more. Seats are nice and plush, feature the same color scheme coming across the door panels. With a comfortable seating position for myself up front, I'm 5'10", I still have about 2-2.5 inches of leg space, and probably about similar in head space. Coat hooks in the rear, as well as rear illumination. Up top, you have a little LED indicator for your rear parking sensors, so you can more accurately gauge how close you're coming to objects. Little quarter windows in the back, breaking up that C-pillar. The back seats also fold, and I'll show that in just a second. nice and plush. To fold the seats back, just grab these little straps here and pull. Yields a little bit more cargo space out of the trunk. And we're gonna check out the rest of the vehicle, shall we?
Trunk space for the LaCrosse measures around 14.3 cubic feet. Quite respectable for a vehicle in this class. You have a nice wide opening, integrated cargo net, and it's further enhanced by folding down the rear seats like I showed you earlier.
Same power and manual adjustments on the passenger seat minus the lumbar.
The Buick LaCrosse Super is definitely quite an interesting vehicle, blending modern technology with historical and traditional Buick performance. A special vehicle that would later serve as the inspiration for many Buicks to come over the years.
Well everyone, I hope you enjoyed this detailed look at the 2008 Buick LaCrosse Super. Be sure to stay tuned next time, there's a lot more where that came from. Take care everybody.